what are we looking for? Gold, silver, diamonds?
Not exactly. We're looking for a different kind of treasure. Recyclables.
How exciting can that be?
Stay with me, my watery friend. You'll see. Bingo! Our first treasure.
It is?
Sure! That plastic bottle has a whole new life waiting for it. Maybe a warm fleece jacket.
And
there. That glass jar would look great in my new kitchen. And if you think that's impressive, take a look at what's in store for these old soda cans.
Whoa, that's a makeover.
Want to shoot some hoops? Those tires will make a great basketball court, or playground surface, or soft landings. The next time you finish the paper, just remember, newsprint is the gift that keeps on giving. Don't forget the card.
So, if this is treasure, what's it all doing in the trash?
Good question. Because recycling is actually pretty easy. All you have to do is separate recyclables from regular trash. Trucks pick them up and take them to a recycling center where they're separated and sorted. Now comes my favorite part. Depending on what they're made of, they're either pulped, melted, crushed, shredded, or pelletized to make new raw materials. Those raw materials then go back to manufacturers who use them to make cool new stuff.
Whoa. Those are made out of that pellet stuff?
Uh-huh. And best of all, using reclaimed materials means we save water and energy and reduce the demand for precious natural resources. And since regular trash ends up in a landfill, the more we recycle, the less we need to fill the landscape with garbage. So when you recycle, you're making a big difference to your environment.
Hey, so this stuff kind of is treasure.
Exactly. So the next time you're going to take out the trash, make sure you take out your recyclables first. What are you doing? Time to go.
I'm out of here.
Driver!
an unusual thing in this conversation, which is unfortunate because desert and solar energy go hand in hand. But I think it's just a really great opportunity for us as a desert school to kind of show what we can do in our environment since solar energy is so important here.
We won second place for the overall competition, and we were the only U.S. team that placed in top three.
We're just really, really proud of the UMLB team for, you know, being the top ranking team in the United States. We think it's a fantastic accomplishment and really a source of great community pride. The nice thing about the house is it's both an indoor and an outdoor exhibit. It's a house, so it has a front yard, it has a backyard, and we really wanted to work with UMLB and our team to integrate it into the landscape. It's not just a house placed on the site and you can go in. It feels like it belongs here and that it lives here. And, you know, the outdoor environment really is as important as what's going on inside. You know, we really vision the Springs Preserve as cutting edge and being able to showcase and demonstrate the latest and greatest in technology and to be able to share that with the public.
We have designed a house that really embodies what it means to be a desert house, and not only in terms of how it's oriented and how the house performs and the way indoor-outdoor spaces work, but just the overall feel of the house and how it integrates into the Mojave environment very seamlessly. Wouldn't feel out of place coming back to Vegas.
The U.S. Department of Energy Solar Decathlon is basically a solar design competition that challenged collegiate teams to come up with a solar home that can reach energy balance, meaning you use as much or less energy than your house solar panel can produce.
Not only did they put together a great proposal to get selected, they've got a great team of approximately 60 students, not including faculty members working on this.
Being a desert school is kind of an unusual thing in this competition, which is unfortunate because desert and solar energy go hand in hand. But I think it's just a really great opportunity for us as a desert school to kind of show what we can do in our environment since solar energy is so important.
We won second place for the overall competition, and we were the only U.S. team that placed in top three.
We're just really, really proud of, you know, the team for, you know, being the top ranking team in the United States. Springs Preserve is